Gilroy, El Paso, and Dayton, Ohio. Just in the last few days, three more mass shootings in the United States of America, three more deaths involving men, women, and children. It goes on and on and on and on. Now, I recorded this show a few days before it broadcast, so for all I know, there have been more mass shootings since then. And I want to, unfortunately, want to talk about it because I've written a lot and I've thought a lot about gun violence in this country. In fact, for a while, my editors used to think of me as kind of the go-to guy whenever there was a mass shooting or other gun tragedy, because I thought about it a lot. I reflected on a lot and what it meant. I do have to say before we start that we've had people like Neil deGrasse Tyson, the astrophysicist, telling us that perhaps our perspectives are warped because in the period of time that mass shootings took the lives of 40-something people, that other forms of death might have taken 100 or 200 or 500 lives. And he got heavily criticized about that on the internet, rightfully so. Let me say before that, though, that of course there's some truth to that. We have a lot of people die every day from lack of insurance, proper health insurance. We have a lot of people die every day from the consequences of poverty, the consequences of inequality. And I do want us to think about those things all the time, every day. But I also want us to understand the interconnectedness between the kind of death that occurs from poverty, from negligence of our fellow human being when they are in need, from allowing the profit motive to get into our health insurance system, that is in fact inseparable from the kind of violent, bloodthirsty strain that has made itself visible in, must I say it again, Gilroy, El Paso, and Dayton, Ohio. Now, again, children were the victims, children were the witnesses. We're not going to do a damn thing about any of this until we address the forces underlying it. Yes, Marianne Williamson was right about this, the dark psychic forces that underlie not only our racism, although we know racism was a motivation in at least two of these three killings, which means it can rightfully be called white racist terrorism, but we need to underlie the forces that underlie that. And, because I've quoted it before, but I'll quote it again, the words of all people, Rudyard Kipling, who, wrote some pretty racist words of himself. But, I couldn't help but think of some lines of his poetry when that young girl was killed alongside Gabby Giffords, when Gabby Giffords was shot. We are done with hope and honor. We are lost to love and truth. We are dropping down the ladder rung by rung, and the measure of our torment is the measure of our youth. God help us, for we knew the truth too young. Children know. Children know the kind of society they've been born into. They hear about these things if they don't have the horrific experience of witnessing them, or worse yet, of dying in them. And so the disease is passed from generation to generation. And we can't forgive Wall Street or give Wall Street a pass, because underlying so much of this violence, so much of this dark psychic force, is the fact that, let's face it, it's not really in corporate America's, in Wall Street's, in the 0.01% interest to stop the blood flowing, if that means that we stop the money flowing from the sale of guns and from the cultural products that in their own way encourage this violence. Although I am, I should say, resolutely anti-censorship. But you know what I am more than anything else? I'm pro-child. And a society that allows its innocent men, women, and children to be killed because of the greed and sickness it refuses to stop will continue to see a parade of violence like that we saw in Gilroy, El Paso, and Dayton, Ohio.